This will be my second episode of my pack ranking, and in this episode I will go into way more details than I had recently, and then I will only discover 5 packs for each video. So I'm giving all packs some scores and then a final score. And the final score doesn't have to match the other ones. The final score is just how good I think the pack is and how much I enjoy visiting the pack. As you can see, all the categories that I'm going to discover is lined up here. So Summerland Chillen is coming in at number 25 spot. So this pack might not have any standout rides at all, but that means that it can still be a good pack. Because this is a really, really charming pack. It has a similar feel to it as Forbes Summerland, which we will discover way later. It is that kind of Summerland park, or German, we'll call it a Feise park, probably. It is, just really charming. It is for families and, most families with smaller kids, I will say. But I had a blast and I'm definitely not a smaller kid anymore. So my top 3 rides and attractions at this park. Number 1 have to be the Mega Wild River. That is a water slide, a wild river water slide. And that was really, really fun. Especially if you are holding to each other's ring. It makes it so much more fun. Number 2 is the Jolly Jumper, the Naughty Jets at this park. And that's just also say something about that it isn't major standout rides that pull this park up. If a Naughty Jet is the second best ride in the park. At number 3 I have Simulator Innator. This is definitely one of the better simulator rides that I've experienced. It is really, really fun. So yeah, the atmosphere at this park is great. It is so charming and so chilled, and yeah, I could imagine being here in a really, really warm summer day would be absolutely amazing. Sadly it wasn't that warm when I visited. So theming and beauty, this park is pretty, I would say it's pretty beautiful and fits in with the nature and stuff like that. Although it might not have that much theming and the rides isn't that pretty either. So it's getting an average score, I would say. And for wide end attractions here, it's actually getting a 6 out of 10. So that might seem really, really high since it doesn't have any standout rides. But the thing was that there was so many other fun rides. I would say from the best ride to the probably 8th, 9th best or something like that, they are pretty much on the same level. So that's just say something about how good the quality was. Because all that these rides were really, really fun. And yeah, we had a blast and we spent 9 hours at this park and that was okay. We didn't get bored at all. So for a final score, I'm giving it a 7 out of 10. It's a great park. Next up, I have Legendia. So Legendia had that one standout ride, which is Leg Coaster, which is pretty much the only reason to come if you're on a trip there. But I have to say that the park is actually quite good as well. It is beautiful in some sections, other sections is not that beautiful. But I get it. The park is probably getting better in the future, I will say. It is a theme park, I would say, but you can tell that it has been an amusement park and still is that in some sections. But they are going for more heavily themed rides now. With the area of Leg, for example, great theme there, the new Dark Ride, which is not that new anymore, but yeah, you get it. The park is most for families, I would say all ages, because it is a family park. But they do have some high-level thrill attractions. The top 3 rides there, this is the top 3 from my visit because I believe that Dragon Wrestling Terminal isn't there anymore. But for my visit, Leg Coaster is definitely my favorite, no doubt, nothing comes even close to that. It is one of the best coasters in Europe in my opinion, and it is just amazing. So smooth, so intense, well-paced, it has everything. Yeah, it is just amazing. Number 2 was the insane flat ride called Dragon Wrestling Terminant. This was so unbelievably intense, which just, pretty much the only thing that I like about it, but it was great. at number 3 spot, we have the Dark Ride, Basilisk, or however that's pronounced. I don't have a clue. But yeah, a pretty well-themed shooting Dark Ride, I would say. Decent Dark Ride, not the best, not the worst. And now for some ratings. The atmosphere, I'm only giving it a 5 out of 10. I think some people will go higher, but the thing is, I think, for example, the area of Leg Coaster, that will get a 8 or 9 out of 10. That is amazing atmosphere, but some sections are not that good. Some sections are just not my preference of atmosphere, with the poppy music playing, stuff like that. That's, yeah, not really for me. I'm more into the immersive atmosphere. So with theming and beauty, this park is beautiful with that big lake in the middle. And it's pretty clean, and the theming is great at some section, but for the lack of theming and for, yeah, the way that this park just is, yeah, a park of two hearts, makes me pull it down and only give it a 7 out of 10. For the rides and attractions there, I'm giving it a 7. It's definitely quality and not quantity when it comes to good rides. But they could improve. If they build some other good high-level attractions, then it will, yeah, get a lot higher score than just a 7. And for an overall score, for my preference, I'm giving it a 7 out of 10. Next up, we have another small park, which is Slagharen. This is so much fun. Yeah, you don't have to spend a full day here because it's not that big and there isn't that many attractions, but there is some really, really good attractions there, I would say. So yeah, this is a little theme park, and it is for the whole family, I would say. Many rides for the kids, many for the, yeah, younger member of the family, and also some for the thrill seekers. It is, yeah, great for variation of rides also. For my top 3 rides, number 1 is with a whole long shot, Gold Rush. That is one incredible coaster. I was blown away about how good this actually was. It didn't look that by like that much on the POV, I will say. And I was disappointed about Fury at Bobbejaanland, so yeah, I expected to like this a little bit more maybe, but this blew Fury out of the water in my opinion. It is so much better. It does everything better than Fury, other than maybe the launches. Much better airtime, much more intense, much better whip. It's amazing. But yeah, for number 2, I'm going with the Freefall, the drop tower there. So the Freefall is similar to, it's actually the same as Cobra-tårnet in Bonbonland. I got stable on my ride, but I'm rating this as if it was Cobra-tårnet because I know it's the same, and I just got a bad ride. And at number 3 spot, I have a Wild West Adventure. That is a decent dark ride, not the best and not the worst. It is pretty good. So now for some ratings. The atmosphere, I'm giving a 8 out of 10. I would say it has that great atmosphere, and the way that they have the whole park themed to Western, that makes in for some really good atmosphere, and the actors there, yeah, it's great, I would say. Really good for such a small park. The theming and beauty here, this is a pretty well themed park, I would say. I think they will improve on the newer days. It looks like that when I saw some footage from the time that they still had the Schwarzkopf Looper at Gold Rush's place. Yeah, it looked like they really improved lately, and I will give it a good 7. Some great theming, not top notch, but good theming. And the rides and attractions there, they are great, not the best. But it's a decent lineup, I would say, something for everyone, and it's getting a 7. And for my overall preference, the park is getting a 7 out of 10. Number 22, I have Holiday Park. I think this is a pretty underrated park because many people just go here for Expedition GeForce, and I'm not gonna lie, I did that as well. But yeah, the park turned out to have some great rides other than just that. Some really, really good rides, and also I quite like the theming. I think it's quite a beautiful park. It's a great park. I would say it is a theme park, and it is for the whole family, because As much as they are known for Expedition GeForce, many of the rides are pretty family based. So the top three rides of the park, number one for sure, Expedition GeForce, nothing come close. Of course, it's one of the best coasters in Europe, in my opinion. It is probably the best coaster in Europe for airtime. It is absolutely incredible. Some of really, really strong, pure ejector airtime. It is amazing. And then at number two, for me, it's Skyscream. I think that is a really, really good coaster as well. A good supporting coaster for GeForce. Really smooth, great launches, great hang time, and some good airtime as well, actually. And at number three spot will be the Drop Tower Anubis. It's a pretty good drop tower, not the best one, but definitely not the worst either. It's a great tower. Now for some ratings. The atmosphere at this park is getting a 7 for me. I know some people who say the atmosphere is dead in this park, and I just don't think that's the case. I love how it's located in the woods, and it has a lake, it has some music playing around. I think it's a great park. The theming in this park is decent somewhere, and somewhere it's not that good. But then it's also a beautiful park, so therefore it's getting a good score, 7 out of 10. And for rides and attractions here, there isn't that much to do here, but I would definitely say that the rides were good, they are really, really good. So yeah, it's getting a 7 out of 10 as well. And for my personal rating at this park, it's also getting a 7. Next up, we have my home park, Legoland Billund. So this is a little theme park owned by Merlin, and it is a family park, mostly. I will say that I go there on friends at my own age, and sometimes even older, and we enjoy it, but we are also coaster enthusiasts and theme park enthusiasts, so yeah, that's probably why, but I think this is a really, really good park. And it is more based for families and kids especially. So that means if you're not a theme park enthusiast, yeah, this might not be a place for you. But I have to say that they do have some rides from the thrill seekers as well, at least one. And talking about that one, it's time to talk about the top three rides and attractions. And it is at the number one spot, Ice Pilot School. This is such a good flat ride. You can literally build your own ride. It is a robot arm, and then yeah, you build the ride and you sit, you take a seat, and then the moves that you choose is the ones that the arm will move. So yeah, that's just amazing, the fact that you can actually build your own ride. That also makes that if you want to, then every ride will be different here. Next up, at number two for me, is the Battle of the Brick. That's the show, pretty new show. And this is a really, really good show. I would say there's elements for the whole family there. It's great, and the actors are doing a great job as well. And number three is the best coaster at the park. That is rare to see, the best coaster only number three at the park. But for me, it is here at number three, Polar Explorer. It's a great little family coaster with some really good positives. And I also have a really unique moment, which is the drop track element. Probably my favorite moment of the ride. It is really, really fun. Also pretty well themed. Other than that, they have some other really good rides like Down, the powered coaster. Such a unique ride with the indoor dark ride section, and then the little outdoor section. Yeah, so much fun. For some ratings, the atmosphere is great here. I would give it a 8 out of 10. The fact that they're playing music almost everywhere, and the theming makes the atmosphere better, there's actors, and yeah, it's great atmosphere. And the theming, yeah, talking about that, there are good themed areas here, pretty heavily themed, not the most heavily themed, but they are really good theming for a Danish theme park, at least. And it is a beautiful park, it's well kept, it's clean, so it's getting a good 8 out of 10. So for rides and attractions here, I'm actually giving it a 7. Some people might say that this is really, really high because they don't have many thrill rides or anything. But I don't really need thrill rides if the family rides are really well done. And they are really well done here. So therefore it's getting a really good score. And for my overall preference score, I'm going to give this the first 8 on the series. And that was the last pack I'm describing on this episode. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye, guys.